Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today we are going to learn how to create V-Ray two-sided material. It makes a material translucent and allows the light to pass through it. We use this material to simulate thin translucent surfaces like paper, curtains, leaves, etc. So without any further ado, let's get started. First, render the scene. This is my current scene. Let's quickly see what is in the scene first. I had done lighting using HDRI and dome light. There is a spare light in each lampshade that is currently off. Important info. It's important to note that in order to get the proper effect, the geometry needs to be one-sided, that is not a box or a shell. This material will give best results when assigned to a single-sided object like planes, etc. Otherwise, it can lead to a much longer render time. In this video, we will turn on the lamp light and apply realistic translucent material to the lamp shade using V-Ray two-sided material. First, apply a V-Ray MTL material to the lampshade and change the diffuse value to 200. That is a light gray color. Now turn on the lamp light and render. You can clearly see that the light cannot pass the lampshade, because the material we have applied is not translucent. Plus, we can't use refraction here, it will give wrong result. To make the lampshade translucent, we will make the V-Ray MTL two-sided material and apply it to the lampshade. Rename it to lampshade. Now connect the previous V-Ray MTL material or make a new one and connect it to the front material of the V-Ray MTL two-sided material. I will connect the previous one. So I will go to my hypershade. This was the material that I was using for my lampshade, and I will drag it here using middle mouse. That is your scroll button. Now render and compare. Make this B, make this A. This is my with two-sided material and this is with without two-sided material. You can clearly see that the light is now passing through it. Now we will look at the V-Ray two-sided material parameters. Front material. These are the front side polygons of your mesh. These faces. According to your normals. Normally the polygons normals are facing outside. Back material. These are the back side or the inside faces of your mesh. According to your normals. If your normal is outside, this is your front side and this is your back side. By default, the back material is disabled, which means that V-Ray will use the same front material for the back material as well. If you want a different material for the back side, for example paper, then add a V-Ray material over here. But mostly you use the same material for both sides. Translucency. It controls how much you want your object to be translucent. Light gray color will pass more light, while dark gray color will pass less light. Let's see some examples. Make the color light gray around 240 and render. Now make the material dark gray around 30 and render. This is my result at dark gray color. Now compare both the renders. This is light gray color, 240 value. This is dark gray color, 30. You can clearly see when the translucency has a light gray color at a value of 240, more light is passing. And when the translucency value is dark gray, 30, less light is passing. Hopefully you understand the concept of translucency here. But I will recommend to use texture to control translucency color. Quickly load a bitmap here and render. This is the texture that I have used here. You can clearly see less translucency or less light passes at the dark gray colors, while more light passes or more translucency at the lighter gray or bright gray colors. I hope guys that this tutorial was easy for you, and now you guys can make translucent materials like paper, curtains, and give your renders a more realistic look. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love this tutorial, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating, guys. Bye.